Hi guys, it's Future Me here. Just showing you the finished product. This is just a simple seam binding. This is moss color from Erin's shop, My Scrap Cabin. This is the folio that we made. I did go ahead and do this off camera, just a little journal card to stick in the pocket. Here is our pocket for our notebook, our mini legal pad. Just slides right on in, and of course I'm gonna make a bugger of it. And then, oh, I need to re-glue that down. I didn't wait long enough before I folded. Anyways, that's our finished product, guys, yeah? Okay, enjoy the video. Hello, all you imps, pixies, and other fine fae folk. It's me, Michelle, of the Hobby Hobbit. This is a channel where we play with different kinds of artsy craftsy things, but we are master of none. To those of you who have just wandered across my channel, I would love it if you would consider giving me a like and a subscribe. It helps my baby channel grow. To those of you who have subscribed and have come back, hi. How are you? How you doing? Welcome back. Right. Here are some shops. 10% off at Erin My Scrap Cabin Shop. She makes that beautiful seam binding. Code HOBBIT10. Tukey Designs, HOBBY75 for 75% off. Also go check out Vintage Paper by Design. She has some cool stuff in her shop. In my description box, there's all kinds of links and descriptions and things to channels to support, product I like, channels to inspire. Today's project is brought to you by... I was binge watching a bunch of Julie from Camellia Craft Designs, and one of her videos was something that she got from Carrie the Crafter, and it was just basically where they were kind of like covering over something. They were stamping and doing all kinds of stuff to make some different colors. Well, she made a folio out of these pages that she was putting on, and I thought, huh, I wonder. My idea is to make a folio for one of these mini legal pads. So technically this is from Julie and Carrie, but it's not, if that makes any sense. And I got a bug scratching at the door. Hold on, let me let her in. We got 3 minutes into the video. Literally 3 minutes. Come on, bug. Right, so... Julie was seeing... something that Carrie was doing where he was stamping on the background and just making these really pretty background pages to put on. Well, instead of doing that, I'm going to use the Tukey Designs. I'm going to use these guys. This is from Tukey Designs. There is a code for 75% off. HOBBY75. But I thought, wouldn't these be cool to use? Yeah. So I'm going to give you the measurements because I've already done some pre, because I didn't want you guys to suffer. So I've already done the pre-measuring and pre-cutting and scoring and whatnot, okay? So I'm going to give you these measurements. This is made out of one of these file folders. Yeah, one of the hanging file folders, okay? Standard issue. This happens to be Office Supplies Group out of Marion, Indiana. Item number HF151. I got these on, I think, Facebook Marketplace or something like that. So I cut it down. The height of this is just over 20 centimeters or just right at 8 inches tall. Yeah. The length I cut, so that you're aware, I cut these parts off. Yeah. So that's all that's missing off of this. I just cut these edges off and then trimmed where I cut because I used scissors because I didn't feel like bringing out my big cutter. So then the length of this, and you got to remember it's going to be like 15 and 3/4. Yeah. Okay. So we're going to go bit by bit here. What I did, I wanted to make sure that I had this fold deep enough that having this is not going to interfere with closing, yeah? What we're also going to do, this is going to be the outside closure. So I scored approximately approximately 2 inches in, and then a half an, not quite half an inch from that, and then not quite. So basically I've scored in, and I can see I didn't really score it quite evenly, but that's okay. So my first score line is at 1. Hang on, let me get there. It's just like a tenth of an inch or 1/16 of an inch less than 2. Then from that score line, we're doing a score at a half, not quite half an inch. It's 13/16 of an inch, I think is what it is, or something like that. I don't know. I should have written all this down when I did it. Let's do centimeters. That might get me better. Okay, so my first score line is not quite 5 centimeters in. Okay, from there we're going 1 centimeter, and then we're going to go about half a centimeter. So that's a half a centimeter, that's 1 centimeter, 5. Yeah. The other side, I have the fold at about 6.5 centimeters, and then a score line at about 4.5 centimeters. This, I think, is going to be a pocket, if I'm not mistaken. What was I going to do with this? This was going to fold over. Yes. This becomes a pocket. And then this is going to be the closure. Yeah. Okay. So that, I don't even know why I did that. I think I was thinking something else and then changed my mind. So this is going to be a pocket here. I also have, well, hello, bug. It's nice of you to meet everybody. Yes. It's nice of you to meet everybody. Because I wasn't paying her enough attention. Off of my cutoff, I have cut or scored it at 13 centimeters. And then I've got just basically, I've scored it about half a centimeter all the way around. Yeah. And then I did the mitering. So this is going to glue down. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm not even going to do that yet because I want to cover these pages. So I want to see what's going to fit where, because I want the bees to show. And then this I could essentially. Yeah. Okay. I could cut this into 2 and then put this on top of this. So it's one big. Yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to try. That's what we're going to try to do. I'm going to put this where it's all nice and even. Okay, now, if I want to do this, right there. I'm like cutting it exactly where it needs to be. Cut that off. Cut you even. Which means now that I've just had to trim that, it's probably not exactly where it needs to be. So we're going to measure again before we cut. You know the saying, measure twice, cut once, right? So that's what we're going to do. Okay, if I want this, yeah, I need to change that mark. Is going to be right there now. Let's get rid of the lower one. Now, we need to come down in width. Can you guys see what I'm doing? I hope so. So what I'm going to do here now is I am going to, I like this side, I'm going to just cut this part off. Yeah. Yeah. I'm just going to cut that off. Which means this should need this to be cut off too. Yes. Actually going to go a little bit shorter than that, and then I'm going to take a little bit off at the bottom because I do want a little tiny bit of the edge to show. There. So now I think a little bit more can come off actually. Yeah, I like that better. Okay, so that means we're gonna need to trim this way as well. Now, I don't wanna lose too much of that wing. So we're gonna cut this side now. I want it to be as even. Oh, wait. I can't do that because I need that to line up. Okay. Glad I thought about that. I am so glad I thought about that, you guys. Right. That looks good. Okay, so now I need to decide what color I want to do. And I think I'm going to go back to my Ground Espresso because you guys know that is my favorite one. It's my favorite one to use. That's Vintage Photo. Apparently I don't have a Ground Espresso out. Good times. I thought I did. I know this looks dark and grungy, but I think it'll be okay once I've grungified everything else and inked everything else. I was contemplating doing the Vintage Photo on the paper and then doing the Ground Espresso on the card, the file folder, but I think I like this. Y'all, I went for a drive today in my Jeep, had the top down, and my shoulders got burnt on one side. Because driving one direction, it hit the sun just right on one side, and driving back hit just right on one side. The same side. Mm-hmm. But it is what it is, right? Okay, so yeah, that's going to be just about right. Go ahead and we're gonna ink it up. 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 Ink it up. We're gonna ink it up. I know you guys have missed the Inky Dinky song, haven't you? Okay, while I'm at it, do I really want to ink this? I should have done this ahead of time. I should have done this ahead of time, guys. I'm so sorry. And I would put you on pause, but, well, I'm not gonna. So yeah, all I'm doing is, actually this is the one I want, this fold here. Actually, I don't need that because that's going to be folded in. That's going to become a pocket, so I don't need to worry about that. Or the inside of that, really. We do want the outside, though. Again, the papers that I'm using are from Tukey Designs. They are linked in my description box. I am going to add a key phrase in here today. What that means is somewhere in this video, you are going to see a secret word or hear a secret word, and it is your job to put the secret word in the comments. But not just as the word. You've got to use it in a sentence so that everybody does not guess what the word is. And then when I have enough entries, I will do a drawing. And then there will be some kind of prize giveaway. You may enter this kind of contest as many times as I have videos using the key phrase for that video. Yeah? So you can't use the same key phrase on multiple videos because they're going to be different words for different videos. It's not going to be in the same spot in every video. It's just going to be hidden here and there. So the phrase for today is going to be Tukey, T-O-U-K-E-Y. And I think yesterday's video, the seam binding from Erin, I think we're going to use the word seam binding. I didn't post it in the video, so if you watched yesterday's video, go back and use seam binding for that key phrase. You feel me, dog? You picking up what I'm laying down? I'm hoping now that I've got Mama home, I'm hoping to be able to film a little bit more regularly and get back on track with my channel. I'm starting to feel like I got some mojo again. If there's anything you would like to see me make or do or try to do, try being the operative word, let me know. Put it in the comments. I have not forgotten. I know I need to film some gnomes in the neighborhood coloring pages. I have not forgotten you. I just haven't had a chance to get around to it. I might do that tomorrow. Or my next video, rather. Right. Now we've quickly-ish gone through and grungified this little folder. Right. Now, that's going to be my closure, so I probably do need to do something on the inside of that. That's the closure. That's not the pocket. I need some water. I'm thirsty, y'all. I'm thirsty. Right. Okay. I think that's good enough. Okay. You can go there. wonder where my other dauber went, because it was like a well-used and well-loved dauber. Okay, so now I want to put this on here. And then this will be here with this on top. Oh, I like it. Don't you, you guys? Doesn't that look great? Yes. Yes, I like it. I like it a lot. Okay. Glue stick. I realize I'm not using a glue book. And that's probably a bad mistake on my part. I don't really use glue books. Okay. I want you to be about, yeah, about like that. Yep, you can be on here. About like that. Smooch you up some. Yeah, I like it. You're gonna line up really nicely. Yep, we like it. Okay, we're gonna use our Lenneco glue. Lineco, Lenneco. It's in my description box. This is a glue that my friend June turned me on to. It is literally made for bookbinding, so it is perfect for paper crafts. It grabs really, really fast. Now, see, did you guys catch what I almost did there? I started to glue on here, which would have been wrong because that's my deep, that's the depth of my pocket. I need to glue on this flap all the way around, okay? So that would have been very bad. Very, very bad. And again, this is in one of those Sugar Bell bottles, so I'm kind of going off to the side and not really squeezing real hard because this stuff comes out like you would not believe onto here. There we go. That's good enough for me. Okay. I don't have much wiggle room with this, so I gotta get it on and get it stuck. And I'm pretty happy with that. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. It gives it room to close on both sides. I'm happy with it. That's lined up on the bottom pretty good. Yep. Okay. And that's not going anywhere. That is stuck. Okay, now let's figure out what we want to put on this side. Actually, let's look at our cover first. And honestly, for the cover, I think I want this. What do you think? Or is that just too plain Jane and maybe I should go for this? I want to keep these ones because I think I want like this, if I can make it work. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to do the same thing with this that I did with this. I'm going to slice that sucker in half and make it work. Or am I? I I think if I do that, I don't want to cut a bee in half though. But each one's going to have a bee that's going to be cut in half. I could do this. Then no bee is cut in half. Okay. Where's the other? So then, front cover. Do we want that? I really like this though. Or perhaps we could do this. Okay, you know what? Because I like this, that'll be the back page, yeah? That's gonna be the back. And we'll do that for the front. I can live with that-ish. Can you hear me pouting about it? I can live with it-ish. See where we need to lose some. I'm gonna have to lose some on each side. I can hear Mr. Marvel Man crying. Little puppy. Poor little boy. Okay, let's just see here. I think that's almost... Oh, that is way too short. I cut way too much off. Okay, so we can't use that one. So I guess we're going to use this one then. That looks more like a front cover. All right, take two. I got a little chop happy there, didn't I? Okay, set you aside. Let's go ahead and mark on here. I want more of this top stuff than not. That's almost right. Okay. So, let's get my pencil. I do want a bit of an edge around it, so I'm going to cut here. And then as far as the depth of this goes, let's get this off first. That's great for the height. Okay, so then the width. Let's notch a little off. There. And take a little off here and see where we are. Still need some more to come off. Okay. that's pretty daggone close to what I want. Yep. It needs to have just a little tiny bit more off. Nope, it still needs a little more. I want a little bit more of the brown showing. I know I'm like nickel and diming it to death, but I know where I want it to be. And that's just right. Okay, so now that I've got this, that's the height that I need it to be. So now I can mimic this on this. Yeah? Because this is the back of it. Oh, Marvel, I can hear you crying, puppy. Little cry puppy. He's gonna be hating it. My brother's gonna be gone for 12 days. So it's just gonna be him and Grammy during the daytime. And then just him, me, and Grammy at night. Yep, that's lined up perfectly. Okay, so now that I know this measurement, which one did I want for the inside pocket? It was this one, right? I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing because this is the at least the height of, that I need. And then from there, we can cut down to resize it for the pockets. Okay. Right, okay, so now let's look and see what we've got. We have this one here, which needs to be cut. Marvel puppy, quit crying. This needs to be cut, we're gonna say, here. No, that's gonna cut off the B. Oh, daggone it. I thought I chose one where the B wasn't gonna get cut. Poop. Okay, we're gonna make a change of plans. This is going to be the inside because it doesn't matter what gets cut. And then one of these will be the top, one of these will be the back. Yeah? So let me go ahead and erase that. Okay, so this now. Can me cut, I want it here. I'm going to actually cut it here. Okay, let's go ahead and do some inking on these pages real quick. Oh my goodness, he is such a crybaby. Now the next question is going to be the flap that goes over it. Do I want to do the same thing and cut the picture, because then that's going to leave me with a big blank spot? I'll show you what I mean when I'm talking about that. Okay, so like here's going to be the cover. If I do that with this, that's going to leave me with this much blank spot. But I can work with that. Can I get all of this B? No. Can I get all of this B? No. Okay, I think this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to put something like this on the edge. That's not going to be any good because it's got a wing. This is going to be good because it's got just writing. You know what I mean? This would be better, though, I think, because it's got more. The white writing's wider, so that's the one that we're going to do for the overflap. Since we've just decided that we cannot cut that B. Or can we? I mean, it would line up, right? It's not like it's not cut now. I'm going to do it, guys. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. Yes, I am. I'm going to do it. Of it. No, I think I do. I want to trim just a little bit more off of it, height wise. Which means all of them need to have the height trimmed. Just like that. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, that's much better. Where on earth did my other daughter go? I don't know. And see, that's the thing, is the other one was like so full of ink that I just barely tapped it, and it was, now I'm like loading this. Excuse me. So I'm loading it instead of being able to ink with it. Ink, 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 ink. Okay, so I'm going to put the back on first because that's going to be the least of my worries. And this is the one we decided for the back. Yes. I know this is super simple and quick, and you guys have probably all done something like this, but I thought it was a cute idea. There's a bunch of little mini tablets that I want to buy, and I thought, ooh, these would be cute little things to sell at a swap. And once you get the fiddle faddling down the first go round, I think you're pretty much okay. Because then you kind of know where you want everything to be. You can line up any measurements and cut lines from there, yeah? There we go. That's what I want right there. Yep, that is exactly what I want. Okay, now we're going to do this one the right way round. And then I need to cut and ink. Where did I have that mark? Right there. Let's just line that up one more time. Painful to look at. Okay, so that is going to be there. I think I cut a little too. Okay, I'm gonna cut a little bit off of this edge. Okay, let's get this down first. Oh, nope. There we go. Man, that's a lot smaller than I thought. Can we peel you up again? Or is that going to stick now? It's good. It's good. It is. It is. It's good. Okay, this needs to come just a little bit more. I did cut it a little shy of where I wanted to. So what I'm looking at here is I scooched this over a little bit. I was going to cut here and thought better of it because of the depth of this, and I should have gone with my gut because then it would have been spot on perfect, and then I would have had that little bit of overhang. So yeah, that was me second guessing myself. I should have done what I originally was going to do. But it is what it is, and it's okay. It's a junk journal. It's not supposed to be perfect. And I'm okay with that. I'm okay with imperfection. I mean, I want it to look good, don't get me wrong, but I'm okay with imperfection. Because I am far from perfect. Ask anyone I know. They will gladly tell you I am not perfect. Yeah, I like it. Okay, so there's our pocket. Now, should I do a little dip? I don't think I'm going to do a divot in this one, because it's already split. You can see the split. I don't think it needs a divot. Didn't take long to grab. I'm just letting it hold long enough to grab. These things are iPen tips for anyone who's interested. I got them on Amazon, really inexpensively. Liked them so much, I bought a bunch more. I mean, I may have a bit of a problem with that kind of stuff, you guys. All right, so now this. We got the back. We got this. Now I want to... I'm going to cut this the same size so that I can see where I want this to go, yeah? And then, what do I want to do for the inside of that? I'm going to have to do something. You know what? No. No, I want the writing. Yep, I do. I want the writing. Okay. Oh, my mom's been sneezing, I guess, all day. Please, please don't be coming down with something. We cannot do another hospital visit. We certainly can't do a nursing home. She is officially out of days for a nursing home. Right, now. I do this here. There's my pencil, and I cut there to there. That means I need here. Poor little bee. Okay, you can go over here. You will go on here. Oh, I don't like that now. I don't like that now. Now, I do like that. I like having that. But we got to find something for this. Something that's going to look better there. So let's just see. What? Okay, I'm gonna pull from this and layer this on top of it. Does that look bad, guys? Should I not have done it? I don't think that looks horrible for the little bit that's going to be showing. I don't think that looks horrible. No, I don't think that looks horrible. I mean, it's not what I would prefer. That's what we can do. Okay, we're gonna cut this off. I'm gonna cut off the wing part. I'm gonna cut this down a bit. And then we'll put this on there. That looks better. Then this like down here or something like that. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Okay. Unky's home. Unky Wunk is home. That means it's going to be a happy little boy. Yeah, we'll do it like a little mini collage there. Yeah. Oh, Marvel is telling Unky all about being left alone. And my brother is going, oh, I know, puppy whoopee. Yeah, I don't want that kind of catty-cornered like that. So it looks like it's supposed to be cattywampus, yeah? This is going to cover some. Yeah, I like that. I like it now. I really like that now. This glue stick is really melty. Now, I just had that sorted. Is that going to be too much of a gap now? Going to peel this up. No, I'm not, because that's going to tear. That does need to be stuck down though, because that did not stick. Yeah, I put that a little too far over. It was supposed to go closer to this side. But I make a point of showing you guys my mistakes, yeah? Okay. That's okay. We're just gonna deal with it. We're going to work with it. Now we just need to come up with, well, I think that's just about perfect there, huh? I can trim a bit of this side off. It'll be fine since that side already cut. Yep, I'm digging it. Can you dig it? We can dig it. Height good? Yep. Yeah, I like it, guys. I like it quite a bit. Get our little fold in there. And she's good. Yeah. All right. So that was a pretty quick and easy little folio that we made. We got a pocket here. So we have pocket here. This is a pocket that our tablet will actually fit into. I know because I measured it. It's going to be a tight fit, but it will fit. Come on. I measured you. Oh, damn it. Darn it. We're going to do this instead. There. So, there we have it. And then I will just do a simple little seam binding for a closure. Yeah? Let me know what you think. Yeah? Okay, until next time. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.